Hi folks, Luca, Sharper Trades. Welcome to the weekly chart analysis. End of the week, end of the month. We're going into August tomorrow. And market today was a little bit of a mixed session, however, closed well. So for a good part of the day, if you can set the one in the chart, market pullback. Even though there was very positive earnings yesterday, Apple, Facebook, Amazon, Google, reported earnings very positive. So many of them popped 4, 5, 6, 8%. And then there were some concern with regards to consumer spending. Found some support though around the lunch hours, after lunch hours when traders came back at 320, 321 area and got a bounce, crossed the VWP, and then went strong into the close, big volume. So this on the daily chart looks good. It's a breakout, big volume. There is this recent high at 327. We need to cross that next week, and then we are on our way to 320, 332, and 341. ATMA, channel bottom, this is these are our support. Below that, the 50 simple, the moving average, this blue line. The NDX also looking good. Looks like a breakout or at least an attempt for a breakout, something like that. We give this similar angle. And for the NDX, 11,134, 11,500. The support ATMA, today got a bounce off of it, this orange line. Below that, channel bottom, obviously. And then for this one is the 34 EMA, the purple line, currently 10,408. 50 is a must hold area, but it's far from being there. The Dow Jones Industrial is recovering a little bit, a couple of days of lower shadow off the 50 simple, the moving average. That's important. Now the angle is shifting a little bit, the more slanted. So the Dow Jones is trailing a little bit, but these couple of days above the 50, it's important. This tells us the market wants to go higher. As long as the 50 holds, this is a key moving average. The majority of money managers around the world watches the 50. And in regards to the Dow Jones, the world watches the Dow Jones, even though it's not an important index with regards to trading. It does affect how investors allocate their capitals in the, throughout the world. We use the NDX and the S&P 500, SPY or SPX. For this one, 27,500, 28,400, 29,500, those are the next resistance areas. And the support, the 50, obviously, and then this low, at 25,523. IWM, the Russell 2000 ETF looks okay. A little bit of a bounce, downbar volume, a couple of downbar volume creeping in. So the low cap, small cap is not as bullish as definitely the S&P 500 and the NDX. The NDX definitely very bullish. It's okay. It's okay. The 50 simple moving average, it's holding, so that's positive. A break below that, we could have some problem down to 136, 130, 124. I don't think it's going to happen as long as the market continues its uptrend. We are in a bullish market, so stay long until we see a reversal. Right now, sideways consolidation, leaning bullish. As long as price remains above the 50, that's the blue line across the whole indices, it's a bullish trend. Going into the VIX, for the volatility, the VIX is getting weaker. It's now just above the 20 simple the moving average. This is the short-term trend. So in the within the short-term trend, the fear is dissipated. Got a little bit of a bounce here in the beginning of June and then rolled over. So fear dissipated then as well. And it could drift further down if it breaks below the 200 simple moving average, this red line, 25, and then there's some support near 23. And the VXZ, this is the midterm. The midterm, the fear is still there, but it's in consolidation. So there's not really much going on. The problem will be if this breaks out of 36 and then they're going up. That tells us the six time period time frame. So the next two quarters, there is expectation that market will pull back further. Right now we are not seeing that quite yet, but they are on the fence. The both bulls and bears are right there and watching. And the gold, the precious metals have been rallying since the Feds have started printing money like crazy to save this economy from collapsing. Is helping, obviously. People are not losing their jobs, their livelihood, their homes, their businesses yet. I've started seeing the appearance of quite a few homes for sales around where I live and places I've seen. And that's okay, as long as there is a buyer. When things stop selling, and then there are more sell, so people stop buying, then we will have a problem in the economy. So as long as you see a turnaround, all people, all owners go and new owners come in, fine. And it's healthy. So anyway, the gold has been running since the Fed have been printing all this money. There is a connection, dollar and gold. And as the dollar is losing value, dollar recently broke below support. The gold has been rallying and reached my target now at 185. My next target is 192 and 200, 199. Above that, if this thing continues to go higher, which not possible because the economy is still in bad shape with, I believe, 30 million unemployed people. There are new businesses popping in, new things working better. But a lot of people are struggling, so very difficult. It's going to take a few years, several years actually, for this to recover. Anyway, so the gold is safe haven and it's moving up. The silver also reached my target, 2269. I'm looking for 24, 25, 57, and 27. And then we got 29. General top, so now the angle is changing a little bit. This is, actually no, that is a breakout. So this goes back to where it was. This becomes the mid channel. And now we have a channel top, which will be somewhere in this area. Yeah, something like that. All right. And for this, the support, the 2140, the ATMA. The oil is struggling to, so the energy sector is weaker for sure. Big resistance at 1135, that's my resistance. Until it breaks it, this will continue sideways or lower. Appearance of a big dumper volume yesterday, never a good sign. However, when he appeared here, what was it, June 11, and then price went up. So we may see something similar. Because it went down when this up bar came up. So it might be the catalyst for the next move up. We'll see. The resistance at 1170 needs to pop. Next target are 13 and the red line 200 simple the moving average. According to the FANG, starting with Facebook. Facebook reported earnings yesterday. A big volume. This is a breakout of the all-time high. Just like Apple, massive move and earnings very positive, big breakout. This could consolidate, but if you start trending 259, 271, 285, and 300 are my next targets. And the support, the recent this high, 247, that's primary support. And the secondary support is down here near the 236 area channel bottom. Apple is a big breakout, big volume, massive move, reached the channel top in the aftermarket market. Looks like it might be extending 427, 430, 450, 470, 500. I mean, at some point, this thing is going to go there. And the pullback today low is your primary support, the ATMA, and then 375 secondary support. Extremely bullish. Channel top. Amazon has also reported earnings, also bullish with a breakout and volume, but then a pullback. Analysts gave some analysts 3,800, 4,000. We're going to go there, get there at some point. There's no doubt. I mean, this is the business that is flourishing. Everybody's using Amazon. Convenient, effective across all sectors, across all departments, I should say. Channel top, we might try to fill this gap and retest 3,000 and the ATMA, this is your primary support. Below that is low, 2,888. That's an important one. But I'm looking for 34, 3570, 38, and 4,000. Amazon and Netflix. Netflix, it's weaker of the five, reported earnings last couple of weeks, bad earnings with the dark cloud. It didn't have a lot of number volume, but it crept in. And then a few days ago, again, big volume, number volume, same as the previous day one. And this is drifting. So it's weaker, it's holding the 50 simple, the moving average, and there's some support trend line. If it breaks this trend line near 470, and moves below the 50, then it will retest 446 and 420. It might be also setting up for the next move. We don't know at this point. It's still showing weakness with the OBV below the moving average. And it's trying to recover now slightly above the 8. But you see here, it popped above the 8 and then went right below it. So we could see gap down, gap down. The bottom line is that if it remains above the 50, it's okay. If it closes below the 50 and doesn't recover, it will go down. If it recovers 333, 50, 533, 567, and 604 are my next targets, above that 640. And Google also reported earnings, not good, went down. This has been mirroring. Mirroring Facebook in terms of the behavior was having, but earnings negative. So this is a big number volume today, just a bounce off the 50. If it fails, it will come down here to the 200 simple moving average, currently 1,336. So that's the next support. The next two support are actually 1380 and then 1335. If this channel bottom, let's see if that, no, this is not the channel bottom, this is the channel bottom. So that's the channel bottom, which is currently holding. And that's the channel top. By the way, those channels change as price moves forward and things change, modify. So you have to change those lines as well. You have to be able to be flexible with those moves. Anyway, if this channel bottom breaks, that's the direction down. And if it holds, then it might try to come back and test this, first of all, 1535, and then this recent high at 1577 and 1587. Next targets, if it goes up 16, 15, 17, 12, and one last target for Google if it gets there. 798. All right, enough with the FANG and the commodities and the indices. Let's get into the individual stocks. The one in the swing group for the swing list, the day trades that we covered today, some, and a few other things that we might want to pay attention next week. Starting with apps. Apps, so this is a swing we initiated yesterday at 13 when it was breaking out with volume. It's working. Nice action today. We reached the target in the pre-market at 13.99. At one point, tried to break out, as you can see here. But then stalled. It was a big resistance at 1427, tried twice and failed. Rolled over, but not too much. Found the support at 1368 and then closed well in the going into the close. Big volume in the after hour market, huge, 600,000 traded shares. It would be the catalyst for the next move. Whenever we see those big ones, the move can go either direction. We are bullish on this one, so we'll hope it's going to go our direction, which is up. Well, you know, always prop yourself with stops. 13 and 12 are primary and secondary support. The chart is very bullish, but it needs to break out this resistance, 14, big resistance. In the after hour market is right there, 1404, BIDAX price. I'm looking for 1563, this is second target, and 1755, third target. Possibly if he extends, we might even see 1944. That's a stretch though. ADTR, this was mentioned several times this week and yesterday broke out. It's setting up for a possible next move. Now, it's now testing, let's see, there is a mid channel. Every time you have a channel top and a channel bottom, this is the mid channel. So it's right at the level. It might pull back and retest 2120, that's your primary support. Secondary support is 20. Okay. But if this is a continuation pattern, so it pops stall for one or two candle, if you have doji's and spinning top, and then the next wave up, if that's the direction, I'm looking for 2340, 2540, 2780. Blink, this was a fantastic swing. We initiated the position here at 750. The following day exploded, good volume, reached the first and second target. And then the following day reached my third target and came as high as 1458. We updated the stops with 13 and 11. And today closed right at 11. So this, it's off the list for now. We took, I mean, these folks came up from 750 to 13, 73%. You're gonna take some profit off the table. Now it's setting up for possibly the next move. The volume is very bullish. But it might come further down to retest the 18A. That would be a good entry, re-entry opportunity, 9. Or even a sideways consolidation above the high at 10, and then the closing 962. So all those areas, the high, the close, and the 18A, those could be possible re-entry opportunities. We'll have to see what it does next week. I'm looking for a sideways consolidation, ideally, and then if it shows some bullish action, which means a cross above 13, I'm looking for 16, 42, 20, and if that's the channel top, we might see at some point 24. This moves very, very fast, so be aware of the risks. BRKS, this was a day trade that worked decent, made a good move, popped here and then consolidated for the entire time, and then rolled over a little bit, found some support at 52.40, and then rallied to 54. So not much of a move, but it looks bullish if he extends 59, 65, and 70. Support, if you're using this as a swing, 52 and 49. CHWY, this is a new idea, and I shared it with the training room for our day traders and those that have joined, that are not day traders. And keep an eye on this one. Big consolidation, multiple tops at with a high of 52.77. If it breaks above it, next week, this thing is gonna fly. Earnings are behind us all the way to September. So we're looking for 55, 60, 66. And if it goes vertical, even 71. The support is the ATMA and then this set of lows near 45. Most importantly, the 15 is the one. Codex, a day trade that worked very well. spotted this sideways consolidation and then broke out, sent you a message from 2340 all the way up to 25, reached my target, 2455, and then extended to 25, and then a pullback broke the channel. And done as a day trade, but this is very bullish. Remember, it was covered multiple times, a few times, last week, when it was pressing this area. And this is very volatile, so I don't like to use this as a swing, especially at this level. It came from 14 up to 24. It can be very risky and moves sometimes in unpredictable ways. But now this is one of the virals. Now with this kind of volume, a million, it's a breakout, big volume. That's what you want to see. Most likely will extend, looking for 25.50. There's some resistance there near 27, 60, 30, and then 34. But 30, that's the big resistance, is the all-time high. Yeah. The support are 22, and this low at 20.50. EBS, another one in the day trading things that were mentioned, didn't do anything. It just moved sideways. Reported earnings, it popped and then sideways. Strong into the close with good volume, could extend, but didn't do anything. So that's it. If he does extend, 118, 124, and 129. Support is today low 103. Etsy, I like it a lot. It was mentioned by Subo, and I saw it in one of the option. Flow, big volume, earnings next week. This is earnings season. I don't like to hold position through earnings. It's can be a double-edged sword, 50-50 binary event, and oftentimes it goes the opposite. Earnings are disappointing, but who knows? Bottom line, I don't trade earnings. I don't hold position during earnings, as I said before, or buy a day after, or even the same day if it works okay, if it's holding the support. Definitely as a day trade for sure. As a swing, not so much. And Etsy is breaking out of the all-time high, 116. Volume is good, needs more to rally. After our market is decent, looks nice. I'm looking for 134, 158, and 184, that's a stretch. The support, ATMA and 100. HMHC, this was covered several times last week when I saw this bullish move here with good volume, consolidated, today made a pop. This is in the education sector, working with online stuff. It's gonna be an important segment in the fall. So they're setting up with a good rally in the next couple of weeks or something. I'm looking for 419 at the 200 simple moving average. And then above that, if it blows through at 530, 680. And the support is the ATMA at 250. and then two. This is very volatile, obviously, so be aware of the risk. The bottom line is that I need to see the ATMA and this low hold. I don't want any lower than that. INSG, one of our swing trades, broke out this day, and then a pullback gave an entry opportunity at 12.40, reached my first target the following day at 13.47, and now is resting there. Yes, it was profit-taking today, a sideways consolidation. At one point, it was trying to break out, 13.8, and then a pullback. There's a resistance at 13.90. I'm looking for second target, 15.20, this recent high. That at that point, if he gets there, take your profit. And if it blows through it, 17.06 channel top, at least peels them off. Yeah. And any pullback, the 80 main is to hold. Primary support is 13, secondary support is 12. KSU, this showed up in the scanner with a massive explosion of price volume. And 177, this is an all-time high. And then a pullback consolidation. There is, at least when I last saw, there was a large buyer at 169 for today. Might go away on next week. And then a big resistance of 192. This needs to break out this all-time high exactly 178.59. If it does, those are your targets, 200, 223, 249. Support 161 and the blue line, 151. KTB, a swing that worked briefly through here and then yesterday showed bearish pressure and today a rollover with a bounce of the trend line closing above 19. For me, this one, as long as it remains above the 19 and the 18A, it's okay. I don't want it anywhere below it because it will come down to fill this gap. And I mean closing. As long as it close above 19 and the 18A, it's okay. And start closing below it, then calls for trouble, which means fill this gap and possibly test the 50 down at 17.76. I'm looking for a recovery. Ideally, I want to see it back above 20, targets 21.18, 23, and 25. Myrna, this is one of the virus-related stocks. I added to the list, I didn't send any message. We mentioned this in the trading room when it was breaking out here. A consolidation for a couple of days and then 3 days of weakness. And it's accelerating today. So this obviously is not working at this point. What I need to see is the back, a move back above the 18A. And most importantly, it needs to take out this high at 84.29. Yeah. If it does 88.93.100, don't try to catch those bottoms because those stocks are very volatile. It might come down and retest all the way down to the 18A, 50 simple moving average. OPK, another virus related that worked very well for us through here, massive move. Enter a position this day and then reached all our three targets in 2 days, basically. And then pull back, we attempted the re-entry here and then failed. And we added back to the list with no new alert, just to watch it and possibly trade it. And yesterday was showing some good action. However, reported earnings today, I didn't see that there was earnings coming. And in the after hour market, it was down. And then got a bounce in the pre-market. And this morning I sent a message right at this level. It was down 5% following negative earnings or earnings with a stop at 550. That was the low and it needed to hold. Chances are it was gonna go lower. That's why I sent you the message. It looked ugly. And it did, bearish kicker, downward volume increase, and analysts give a target of 10. Forget about it. This is gonna go down to 440 before it makes any reversal. And so this is done. PFE, this is also another virus related, added in the list, nothing done yet, was mentioned, was a day trade here, and then a day trade here. It's stalling below 39, and they're working on a vaccine, but they're mainly affected by the decision of the Trump administration to lower the drug prices, which frankly, I'm a big proponent as well. But in terms of stock prices, it's making prices move sideways. Okay? So this is stalling and it needs to close back above 39.40 before it makes the next move, 41 and 43 are the targets. Support are super tight, 38 and 37. PSTI, keep an eye on this one. A lot of inside trading people within the company that are buying CEOs and directors down, let's see, near the 8 level, near the 850, and then near the 9. Today found some resistance at 10, by the way, legal inside trading. Those are documented, they're posted. Director bought such and such number of shares for this company. CEO bought or sold such number of shares for this company. Okay? So it's all been transparent. And 10, big resistance. If it blows through it, 11, 12, 50, and 15. And it pulled back the ATMA and the 50, ATMA being 9 and the 50 8:30 must follow. The technicals look very bullish. Volume is picking up, so it looks interesting. Anyway, those are ideas. Peton making a move. I like it. Today volume is increasing. There is a big resistance, the all-time high is 70, 69.73. If it pops through it and holds, looking for 72, 35, 77, 83. Support 80 MA, and this low at 60. Sorrento, SRNE. Big move yesterday with decent volume, and today exploding the pre-market. This was a day trade. It worked for part of the day. I have to go inside this. I was pushing through here, and then as soon as he opened, he made a good move. He rallied from 960 to 1050. And then there was a big resistance. Sent a message every time there was a big resistance, and the resistance kept moving lower and lower. So that was the indication that this thing wasn't going to go anywhere. It tried to break out here with some volume, but didn't get the follow through. And then that was it, went down. Might have found the bottom now. It's now back above 9. Keep an eye on it. Not this one. Keep an eye on it because the volume is bullish and it's a breakout and it's holding the support. So the support is today low 860. If this area continues to hold, they might have a shot to reverse. Now this is all over the place. We swing traded for a few days and then broke the support and might be a channel top. So if that's the channel top, it needs to cool back further, which means could come down and test the channel bottom. I don't think it's going to happen with this kind of volume, but it's always a possibility. So for now, the today low and the 80 May, those are the supports. See what it does. If it comes back above 967, bigger resistance than 50, then it can go higher. 11.11, 13.15. WTRH, this was a beautiful swing for us when it broke out here. We entered 420, a pullback, and then rallied, started rallying, breakout, and reached the big target here was 549, came very close to that, 543, and today reached it. This is not on the list, but I might be adding it back to the list. Reports earning in 2 weeks, so there might be some time to still play with this one. Technicals are very bullish, both the OBV and the balance of power. A move above 550 with volume, we could see 680 and 860. Support is the 80 MA and then this low at 461. And finally, Zillow initiated the position yesterday at 69 when it was breaking out of this resistance. Today I pull back, actually in the pre-market was higher, around 71.48 was the high. As soon as the opening went down, mirroring the market, and then got a little bit of a bounce. So this is, we have two support, 67 and 64, they're both very tight. It's finding some base. Now this is, the all-time high is right here, 69.40. Try to break out. Yesterday did, today pull back the test. Number volume increased, smaller than yesterday. Yesterday is not a huge volume. I need to see more volume to get the push through it. We need to see our first target is 73.40, eight above that 82 and 91. Earnings on the six, hopefully we get the move before it. Unless, and if we don't, this will come off the list because I don't like poor positions through earnings. Well, folks, thanks for watching. Enjoy your weekend and we'll see you on Monday. Good trading.